Another very important part of fungi, that is reproduction in fungi. Before I go into the discussion, I would clearly want to mark here that fungi mostly reproduce by sporulation. They undergo spore formation, okay? But then there are also various other types of mode of reproduction that can be seen in fungi during certain kind of periods, and that also we'll be discussing in details. Alright, but then before we go into details discussion, I want you to properly understand and learn this chart. Let's see. Fungal reproduction mainly has been divided into three distinct categories. One is vegetative mode. Vegetative mode means here no spatialized part would be formed in the fungal body before reproduction. So from the fungal hyphae itself or the fungal cell itself, directly an offspring will be born. Now under vegetative mode, we'll be discussing five types: fission, budding, fragmentation, sclerotia and rhizomorph. Likewise, if we enter the next category, that is sporulation or spore formation, okay? Now, as I have told you, spore formation is the main category of reproduction in fungi. It can be again of three types, because in fungi, three different types of spores are born. One category is asexual spores or mitospores. These are spores formed by mitosis, alright? So they are asexual spores. Under asexual spores, we'll be discussing zoospores, sporangiospore, oidia, conidia and chlamydospores. Likewise, under sexual spores, which are born by meiosis, so we call it meiospores as well, they also are of two types, ascospore and basidiospores, alright? Likewise, there are certain kind of spores formed in fungi which possesses two nuclei rather than one. We call such spores to be binucleate spores. So binucleate spores in fungi are of three types: acidiospore, uridospore and teleutospore. Alright, now moving to the sexual reproduction in fungi. Sexual reproduction in fungi consists of three phases, alright: plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis. Likewise, sexual reproduction in fungi also possesses five types of gametic fusion, okay? The planogametic copulation, gametangial contact, gametangial copulation, spermatization and somatogamy. Alright, so first all of you learn this chart properly, only then go into details discussion to avoid any confusion. Alright, so let's move into details of this topic. Now let us discuss the fungal reproduction in details. Alright, so we will start with vegetative mode. See here, vegetative mode of reproduction means a mode of reproduction in which the parental body or cell would not bear any spatialized part prior to reproduction. So that means the somatic cells of the body of the parent will directly give rise to offspring. Okay, so now see, vegetative mode can include so many different forms again. First is fission, as in binary fission, which all of you know very well. So in binary fission, the parental cell will, under favorable condition, divide into two daughter cells. Alright, so parental cell here is dividing into two daughter cells. Right, now very important thing is that fission will only take place in unicellular fungi. Okay, fission would not take place in multicellular fungi which bears hyphae. So rather, it will only be present in unicellular fungi, and the unicellular fungi that's commonly known is yeast, isn't it? So example is yeast. Next is budding. Again, budding is also a mode of reproduction which will only occur in unicellular fungi. So again, common example will be yeast. Now you know very well, in budding, the parental cell during favorable condition will bear a minute projection that will be known as the bud. Eventually, the bud will also undergo karyokinesis, that means as the parental nucleus will divide, one of the copy of the nucleus will enter inside the bud. Eventually, the bud will detach from the parental cell and will start living as an individual organism as a new offspring. Okay, so do remember, budding is also going to be occurring only in unicellular fungi, that is yeast. Next, fragmentation. Now, regarding fragmentation, see, fragmentation will be occurring in multicellular fungi which bears fungal hyphae or fungal filaments. Okay, so as you can see, it's also a very simple process. The fungal hyphae will break down into several fragments or pieces, and each piece will give rise to a new individual or new hyphae. All right, this will be commonly seen in agaricus. All right, now next is sclerotia. Now, sclerotia is a dark colored hard mass formed by a compact mass of hyphae. Okay, this is mainly seen in higher fungi, Claviceps. All right, now next, coming to rhizomorph. Now, if you split the term rhizomorph, you get the meaning already. Rhizo means root, morph means form. So that means this is a structure that has root like features. All right, so what is it all about? See, sometimes during unfavorable conditions, especially when there is lack of food in the substratum of the fungi, at that time the fungal hyphae, which otherwise usually spreads, isn't it, to absorb more and more of food, now during unfavorable condition, the fungal hyphae, instead of spreading in the substratum, it now starts becoming compact. It starts becoming a compact mass and will give rise to root-like or, you know, cord-like or rope-like structures. These rope-like or cord-like structures are called rhizomorph. They will now start penetrating deeper inside the soil or the substratum and will also absorb nourishment whenever possible. So isn't it behaving as root then? So that's why the name is given to be rhizomorph. Alright, example is another higher fungi, Armillaria, okay, commonly also known as honey mushroom. Fine. Now, moving to the second category of reproduction, that is sporulation or spore formation. How vegetative mode is different from spore or sporulation is that in vegetative mode, I have told you, there is no specialized part formed in the body of the fungi prior to reproduction, isn't it? But in sporulation, prior to reproduction, spores, specialized parts or specialized structures called spores are born prior to reproduction. And when those spores will germinate, then there will be new individuals or new hyphae that will start forming. Understood? So in vegetative mode, no specialized part was involved in reproduction. In sporulation, specialized parts called spores are involved during reproduction. That's the difference. That's why we have separated them as per category. Okay. Now, sporulation, you know very well, can be of various types again. So starting with asexual spores or mitospores, because they are formed by mitosis. Now, asexual spores can be of various types. First is zoospore. Now, as you can see in the diagram, zoospores are these minute pear-shaped structures which are biflagellated. As because they have two flagella, they are motile. Flagella is after all a locomotory appendage, isn't it? So they are going to be motile. So these zoospores are going to be formed inside this sac-like structure which is called zoosporangia. Okay? Now, important thing for you to remember here is that zoospores are mainly born in aquatic fungi. For example, Phytophthora, Albubo, etc. Alright? Now, moving to the next one, sporangiospores. Sporangiospore is born in a specialized hyphae called sporangiophore. Now, as you can see in the diagram, sporangiophore, the hyphae, will eventually end up into a swollen region that's called columella. And the columella at its tip will bear a sac-like structure that's called sporangia. Now, inside the sporangia, minute tiny spores will be present. That's called sporangiospores. Alright? Now, sporangiospores are also going to be, that means, present inside a sac-like structure. That's sporangia. Ok? okay. Likewise, zoospores are also born inside a structure, inside something. It will remain covered inside a structure, that's called zoosporangia. So do remember here an important thing. Whenever spores are covered, okay, or whenever spores are born inside a structure, we call such spores to be endospores. So both zoospores and sporangiospores are endospores. Alright, example will be rhizopus and mucor. Alright, next, conidia. As again you can see in the diagram, see here, conidia are also born in specialized hyphae called conidiophore. Conidiophore usually bears various branches and then at its tip will bear conidia, tiny spores which are not born inside any structure. So they are going to be present naked at the tip of the conidiophore. Alright, so conidia are exogenous spores, do remember. Alright, also conidia are known for being very colorful. They can be of different colors according to the species in which they are born. Alright, example would be Penicillium aspergillus. Fine. Now next is Oidia. Now, oidia are only born in certain kind of specialized conditions, say when in the fungal substratum there is too much of water or salt or sugar concentration. At such a kind of condition, the fungal hyphae starts breaking down into minute tiny spore-like structures. So the fungal hyphae starts breaking into small structures and they will be termed as oidia. So oidia, whenever it will fall on a suitable substratum, will germinate and give rise to new hyphae. Alright, example is rhizopus. Last one is chlamydospore. Now chlamydospore will be only born during unfavorable condition and these are very, you know, highly resistant spore. They can survive unfavorable condition for a very long period. So they are highly resistant, thick wall spore formed in certain fungi to survive unfavorable condition. Example is Candida. Alright, so I hope this part is clear to you. Next, moving on to sexual spores or meiospores. Okay, meiosis is mainly a type of cell division in which gametes are born or gametes are formed. And of course, you know, gametes are directly associated with sexual reproduction, isn't it? That's why whenever spores are born by meiosis, we call them sexual spores. Alright? Now, sexual spores or meiospores in fungi are of two types, ascospore and basidiospore. Alright? First, ascospore. See, ascospores are born inside a sac-like structure. So, what kind of spore will it be? Endospore. Okay? So these are endospores born in higher fungi, that is Ascomycetes. Alright. Now as you can see, this sac-like structure is called ascus, or in plural we can also call it asci. Okay. Each ascus will bear 8 ascospores, mainly arranged in this fashion. Okay. And they are mainly endospores born by Ascomycetes. Fine. Next, basidiospores. Basidiospores, on the other hand, you can see these are the spores that are not covered by any structure. So these are exogenous spores born in a club-shaped structure that's called basidium. Okay? Basidium at its tip will bear certain minute finger-like projections which are called stigmata. And at the tip of stigmata will be born 4 basidiospores. Okay? Example will be Basidiomycetes. Fine. Next, binucleate spores. Binucleate spores are spores which have not one, rather two nuclei. So they are of three types: acidiospore, uradospore, and teleutospore. You can know them by their structure. They are structurally differentiated, but all the three has been observed to be developed in the life cycle of one fungi. It's a higher fungi, that's Puccinia. Okay, Puccinia is a parasitic fungi. It causes wheat rust. It causes rust disease in wheat. Okay, and in Puccinia's life cycle, all the three types of binucleate spores have been developed or have been observed to be developed. Okay, so that's it regarding vegetative and sporulation part of reproduction. Next, let's discuss sexual reproduction.